let's try this again. Full stream Twitch since you could issues can't work at the moment. Oh, yeah, good shot, man. College student, and that made me think about how I used to be behind like 2 years up till the end of middle school. Really? I used to be behind 2 years? That's interesting. What part do you think is weird, Hans, that you used to struggle with school and now you're going to college? Like just that fact that you're not going to higher education when education itself was a kind of a particular challenge for you? I think so much of the problem with education is social. It's not, I mean, don't get me wrong, like the way in which people learn shit is kind of outdated. You know, it's obsolete. It's not, it could definitely get a bump, you know, like education could be renovated, right? But I mean, a lot of the issues there are, you should still be in high school? Oh, so you did a turnaround. Well, are you nervous? I mean, enjoy it, dude. You're a smart guy. You know, enjoy it. And make it work, man. You learn more from YouTube than a... Yeah. Well, because YouTube mixes video, you know? It's audio, video, and it's very direct, and people are talking and explaining things in a normal voice, it's so much easier to break that down. Reading is still very good. I mean, it accesses like different parts of the brain, but and forces your imagination to sort of reach further for, you know, cognition. But it's just not as entertaining. So emotionally, if people did, they tend not to connect. College wasn't for you. No. I struggled with college. I got through out of sheer fucking stubborn will. Yeah. And that's rare. That's rare. I feel it's getting more and more rare with every generation. But I appreciate reading too. I wish I did more reading. I don't do nearly as much reading as I used to. I used to read a lot as a kid. But now, I feel like I'm in just like a different time. And there's not a lot of time. And even my own brain. Like if I try to read at the wrong time of day, I just fall asleep. Which just sucks, because if you stop learning, that's when you start getting old, like real fast. Motherfucker. Here they shamble. Nope.
Cogs. Cogs, please help.
Wow, this guy. Listen, blue man. I don't appreciate what you're fucking doing. Another one? Oh my god. Bunch of assholes, swear to god, everywhere you go. I had to switch out of high school. I had to go to an alternative high school. Otherwise, I was gonna drop out. It was getting really bad, man. Really bad. You know, I was cutting every fucking class. Was passing exams, but I was not doing homework. I wasn't doing any extra assignments. Stay home and play video games all the time, man. Or I would go meet my friends, play basketball. And it wasn't like I was getting high or doing anything. Sometimes I'd just be in my bed, stressed the fuck out, like feeling trapped. You know, I feel like I was having like teenage panic attacks. I wasn't having the heart issues or the hot flash issues, but I was having like a mental fucking like. I don't know. I was going through a weird time, man. Not good with anything that does involve control in your hand. Don't say that. Because you're whittling yourself down like you were evolved specifically to handle a controller. I understand that you're sort of being silly and whatnot, but at the same time, I do believe that there's always this potential, right, to people and what they can do and what they can achieve and what they will believe in. And I think that searching that out is one of the most beautiful things that a person can like do, you know, in their life. They to figure that out, you know, I mean, it's really wonderful. So even when you don't know like what to do or where to begin, I definitely think that you should always enjoy that pursuit. And never settle, especially if you're a young guy. You know, controller, let's call that phase one, you know? Thanks, Steel. Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it. That's actually your only skill? No, that's not true. Well, that's the thing, you know, it's funny. Whatever we label a skill, you know, we like what do you define as a skill? Something that you're good at, and you're only good at something because like you applied yourself, right? So if you took the time and you only apply yourself when you care about something, right? So if you found something that you cared about that was, let's say, commercially valuable, then you would be you would be more you would feel like you had more, let's say, upfront value to society, right? But you apply yourself to something that is fun for you to do. And I think that the reason why you did that is because you're a young guy. You're young, you know, you like enjoying yourself. That's one of the most basic things that people do. As you get older and you start to see causes that you want to support, you will be interested in the skills, emotionally interested in the skills that you'll need to be useful in those areas. And it could be anything, you know, but you'll be doing it for other people. And that will expand your tool set. Most kids don't like school because school does not relate to their daily lives. And where if you found a way to make school relevant to a kid's daily life, like to help them understand, like for instance, I have a theory that if you tell the kids that people are ready, like the world needs them to get their shit together right the fuck away. And so they're gonna learn skills in, you know, business and in technology because that's the way of the world and we're learning this right now and we want these kids to be on the forefront so they can start making money and start contributing their ideas as soon as possible. And so we're gonna construct a curriculum that is issues based. So if you as a young person decide you're kind of curious about what's going on with global warming, all right, we're going to start to tailor all of the experiments that we do around global science or like environmental science or whatever. If you as a kid are very curious about making a lot of money to help your parents with some issue that they're having, you know, like financially, we're going to teach you about business and entrepreneurship and, you know, fundraising and finding investors and stuff like that and managing other people. If you're somebody that really likes the science behind, you know, like sports, medicine or training or whatever, you know, we're going to curtail a lot of these things to sort of talk about the things that these people, you know, use in the fields that you're interested in, you know. And I feel like, if you did that, if you took a group of kids and you went around the room and you really asked them, well, what's important to them, and you told them that if they don't get involved in it, then it could be manipulated, abused, corrupted, right? So we need them on point and investing themselves in this thing ASAP. Then I feel like people would feel useful, necessary, valuable, and the grades would reflect their ability to actually work in the field that they care about, right? It would be tied directly to what they believe is important, you know? And I don't know. I don't think it's crazy. That's just one of the reasons why if I'm able to do something where I can help people get work doing things that they enjoy, working on creative projects together, that's kind of like how I would want to support a nonprofit after school program in the arts. But that's like, it's like a pie in the sky kind of, you know, hope.
Need some help over here.
I need fucking support.
A bit better.
Goddamn game. Uh-oh. What? A fucking second.
Look out, take her.
Oh my god, two takers? Such bullshit. Oh my god, okay. Can I just maybe get to the back here? I'm just gonna get the fuck out of here. Alright. Yeah, so, you know, I feel like there are solutions around all of us, right? There are solutions everywhere. But once you find it, you have to then do the work of putting it into reality. And along the way, the solution, the form of the solution, is gonna change because life is just like that. People will funkify the original plan you had, and the reality of whatever it is you're pursuing will change how you need to approach it. I mean, there's just, but that adaptation will make you stronger and more capable over time.
Hang on here.
I just feel I was really being taught things that were important. Yeah, Hans, I mean, that goes without saying, you know? Like, my wife is having a hard time getting the curriculum that she's been given into the minds of her students, and she doesn't have the authority to change the syllabus or anything like that to be more engaging, you know. So she often deals with the frustration of students who are just disconnected and is trying to make it fun and interesting, but there's only so much she can do, you know. She needs to be able to read her classroom, and this is why education needs to be reconsidered in today's day, because teachers need to be flexible so that they can meet their students. And the classrooms need to be smaller. She's a teacher for biochemistry in college. Well, she teaches chemistry, organic chemistry, inorganic, whatever. I mean, it's whatever the chemistry department decides based on her relationship with it, but